How many times have you wanted to find a command in your terminal and ended up doing this? What if I told you there's a way to fix this problem with one command forever on every machine? I used to be in the same boat until I discovered that I could save every command permanently and search through them using a fuzzy searcher. This means no command will ever be lost again. But that's not all. I also found out that I'm not limited to my current machine. I could sync my command history, pull it from different locations, filter the results and search them, all from a slick, easy to use interface. This has made my terminal usage completely frictionless, and if you know something about me, is that I always try to remove friction from my workflow. Today, we're diving into the command line history and showing you how to fix your terminal experience instantly. The first and rather straightforward solution to the history search mess is using FZF. With a simple installation, it takes over Ctrl-R and turns the history command list into a fuzzy searcher, where you can quickly find what's lost. However, while this is a great solution, it's temporary. If the terminal emulator restarts or the tmux server crashes, your very long command that syncs local containers with AWS is now gone forever. What if you could pop the entire thing into a beautiful TUI that actually stores things in a local database? This is exactly what Atuin does. Atuin is a magical shell history tool. With over 18,000 stars on GitHub, this Rust-based project is growing in popularity and offers a wide range of features, customization options, and integrations with different shells and systems. It is an excellent tool to enhance your terminal workflow. There's a community where releases, fixes, and features are announced, and you can ask for help and guidance. The website provides everything from demos to blog posts and comprehensive documentation to get you up and running quickly with a deployment that suits your style and preferences. Check it out on GitHub and atuin.sh. Atuin is amazing. It keeps track of the last time a command was run, how long it took, what the exit code was, and even the path from where it was fired. You can use it to filter based on the host and the session, just like I'm doing here. To get Atuin, all you have to do is run the simple one-liner you get from the docs, and in a few seconds, you're all set. It will suggest a couple of additional settings, but let's ignore them for now. Stick around till the end to see what these are doing. You don't want to miss that. With Ctrl-O, we can even inspect a command, going further into the details of the command itself. The preceding and following commands, stats about its runtime, exit code, and even a small calendar showing when it usually runs. Maybe the first thing you'll notice when starting to use Atuin is that it uses two main key bindings to run commands. If I hit tab on this CL, for example, it'll put it back in my prompt, ready for editing. But just running a command directly from the list is as simple as hitting enter. I just love simple solutions like this that only take one or two strokes away from my previous workflow, but make things a tiny bit nicer and peeling away another layer of friction. Hitting Ctrl-R again, or just scrolling below the last results, tucks away the UI. It's also responsive, so if you launch it in a small pane, for example, it'll get rid of the fancy borders and keep only the essentials in a compact style. I actually prefer that to be the default style everywhere, and I'll show you in a bit how you can configure that on your own. If your terminal supports mouse scrolling, since Atuin maps itself to the up arrow, Ctrl-R, and every other history search command, even the mouse scroll pops it up immediately and hides it if you scroll back down. Unless configured otherwise, the history is stored in a local SQLite database called history.db, sitting under the home directory at .local/share/atuin. If you really want, you can query the database to find one main history table and the schema of timestamp, duration, exit code, command path, etc. And while we can use simple queries, there's no point, as Atuin comes with a bunch of additional CLI options for every type of query you can think of. Atuin history list is a simple history query, just like running Ctrl-R. You can run it with -c to search in the current directory, or --human to use a human-readable format. To configure Atuin, we can create the classic config file under home/.config and make sure our favorite settings are in place. We've got a boilerplate ready in the path, so let's just use it to change the filter to exclude AWS commands, for example. I'll run an AWS command and run the tool again, just to make sure nothing was logged. This way, if you're worried about Atuin keeping data with sensitive information, you can filter commands by regex. Honestly, there's nothing to worry about, and even with its sync options, which we'll see in a bit, there's end-to-end encryption, but we like to be on the safe side. We can also filter commands that aren't needed in the history, like cd, ls, and its different flavors. Atuin prune then deletes the history entries, matching the history filter configuration parameter. The search option gives you even greater power by directly searching results, like AWS commands, for example, or just commands for Atuin. If I add minus I, this pops an interactive session, which is basically the default tool's UI. You can also search by exit codes, use minus C or minus minus CWD to see what was run in the current path. And this makes so much sense when running through repos working with GitHub or Kubernetes cluster. And the coolest bit, you can gather stats on your entire activity, showing top run commands. You can see I'm making heavy use of kubectl, running aliases for kubectl get, delete, get pods. I also run a lot of NeoVim apparently, followed by kubectl apply. Okay, up until now, this is a huge improvement to my workflow, but we haven't really touched Atuin's killer feature, its sync system. Let's see what that's all about. If you remember, earlier after the installation, Atuin suggested we register and log in. What this does is by default creating an account with the Atuin backend. This allows for a secure sync remotely. For obvious reasons, you might want to put things on your own server, to which Atuin offers a bunch of solutions for pretty much every platform you can think of. Once logged in, I can run sync, and when that's ready, the sync tells us where we stand with local and remote servers. So let's go ahead and sync a remote server. To do that, I'm going to use my local Zima board. Shout out to Zima for sending over this super little machine. This little beast has a quad-core CPU with 8GB memory. It comes with every port I need, including a PCI socket so I can easily extend it. I wasn't paid to say any of this, so it's just a huge thank you I want to say to Zima for sending this over. Check them out at zimaboard.com. The board is now up and running. I'll SSH into it and run the installation script. Then a quick login to the same account, to which I need to provide a couple of things. A username, my password, as well as a key that I can get from the original machine using a twin key command. That's basically it. Once I'm logged in, the sync command downloads everything from the remote server, and a quick history list shows everything from my main host on my local remote server where I can keep working. How sweet is that? Obviously, the terminal user interface is ready to go with everything, as if I never left localhost. A quick word about .files. While Atuin started as a tool to store and sync command history records, they're now trying to leverage the same sync system to handle .files. This is not fully implemented yet, but there's another quite popular project named Chez Moi, stands for My Place in French, which has the exact same functionality set up if you're interested. I'll leave a link below so you can check it out. What Atuin can do for you at the moment is sync shell aliases and environment variables, a feature that can be extremely useful if you're moving across machines. That said, these can all be set up with deploying your actual .files and syncing them across different instances. And while you can use external tooling, I've recently covered my end-to-end workflow for setting .files from scratch, linking them with Stow and pushing them to GitHub, including the reasoning behind it and what I've gained from doing that. The video is up here if you want it. Having your terminal set up for history search and command organization is great, but that's just a fraction of what's possible. That's why I've got you covered with a video covering my entire workflow end to end. Check it out right here. And thank you for watching, subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one.